If you join me in our call to worship, found both on the screen and in your bulletin. The Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace.
I will lie down and sleep in peace, for you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety.
Lord, you establish peace for us. All that we have accomplished, you have done for us.
But listen to what God the Lord will say. He promises peace to his people, his saints, but let them not return to folly.
Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men, on whom his favor rests.
You will go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills will burst into song before you, and all the trees of the fields will clap their hands.
Let the peace of Christ rule in our hearts. Since as members of one body, we are called to peace as we worship together.
Our opening hymn this morning is Angels We Have Heard on High.
Angel.
Christmas carols to squeeze in, so we're now to three songs a Sunday. So if you join me, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Thank you. suddenly a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared to the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body we are called to peace, and be thankful. Lighting a candle is a simple yet profound act. It is a testimony to the power of light over darkness. As we light the second candle of Advent, we continue our journey to Christmas. The second candle of Advent is called the Peace Candle. As we anticipate Christmas, let us remember the birth of the Prince of Peace. Let us remember our need for a Savior to save us from our sins and give us peace with God.
One day rule the nations. Did you know?
Midweek, I called Becky Butler up and I said, do you believe that God exists? And she's like, yes. I said, do you really believe that God exists? And she said, yes, why? So last week, for those of you that weren't here, I said, hey, if there's a Christmas song that you want us to sing that may or may not be in the bulletin, send me a text, shoot me an email, put it on a sheet and put it in the thing, and Sandy will get it to me. So the first one I received was from Betty Cumming. So Betty, you got a different bulletin today, and I totally blew the surprise by screwing up the screen. But Betty's bulletin did not say, Mary, did you know? It just said, special music, Dwayne Hough. But she requested, Mary, did you know? About 20 minutes later, I get a email from Dwayne, I'm going to sing Mary, Did You Know for special music this Sunday. So I thought, did Dwayne talk to Betty? Did they? Because I saw Becky hand out some music to Dwayne last week, but I didn't know what they did. And I thought she was saying, sing this, Mom wants it, this is what you need to do. When in fact, it was just a God thing. So Betty, thank you for sending me that text message this week, because it really warmed my heart that God is alive and working in our world. Oh, shoot, I just ruined the surprise. I'm bad at ruining surprises today. Did you hear that? What'd you hear?
Bells.
What?
Bells.
Bells?
Yeah.
Bells will be ringing. It's that time of the year. So, but the first request I got for a song, do you remember what it was? You told me what your favorite song was that you wanted us to sing. So, since you won't play the piano for special music, I thought that we would, I brought a bell. There's a bell for you. There's a bell for me. You don't remember what you said your favorite, you weren't gonna put it on? You don't want to look like a goofball? Oh my goodness, peer pressure. Well, do you remember what the songs were?
What were your requests, Mom?
Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So, I thought we would sing Jingle Bells. Are you going to sing? Or do you think they can hear that? Do you think Grandma Carol can hear that? Can you hear it, Grandma?
You should write us all Jingle Bells.
Oh, all right, there you go. So, those are my grandma's old jingle bells. So, we're going to sing for you. You got to participate, though. Can you do that? Okay. Do you know how it starts? Dashing through the snow. It's got a jingle
bells. Open sleigh. O'er the fields we go. Laughing all the way, bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle.
So that was actually trickery on my part because I wanted to do some special music. So this was your debut doing Jingle Bells in church. But do you think it would be fun to ride in a one-horse open sleigh during a blizzard? Oh, what fun. You think that'd be fun? No heater? No heated seats? Nothing. But a lot of people made a lot of sacrifices and went through a lot of hard times so that we could have the wonderful things we have today. So thank you for telling me one of your favorite songs. I'll fit Rudolph in somehow. I gotta keep looking in my garage to see if I can find something. Okay? Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for Willow and for just her willingness to share her favorite song and for her musical debut here at St. John's. I just pray that you'll bless her during Sunday school and touch her in a special way this week as we all look for peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Wayne.
I got a joy. We finished harvest season this year. Mine finished yesterday, and we only had 9 flat tires, and the cars break down, and the combine broke, so it's been pretty good this year.
Sounds like the sailor farm. If there are no others, then let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we do come to you this Advent season to ask for your peace. We thank you for your loving kindness, for sending your Son into this world that the world might be saved. And we just pray that you will help us to be mindful of that saving grace this week. We do bring many joys to you today. We thank you for this good report on Mila. We thank you for this wonderful report on Tim Linden. We are thankful for the joy of the harvest being finished for many farmers, and the fields are empty, and the harvest has been plentiful this year. So we bring you thanks and glory for that. We thank you for Shannon and that her surgery was successful this week. We pray that you will be with Steve Hall as he continues to recover in the hospital, that you will be with him, be with his family. For Bill Horn, as he has his knee replacement this week, we just pray that you will just help him and the doctors. We thank you for Emily and that she's passed her boards this week and that Patrick has found a fellowship and the joy of a new adventure of moving. We do lift up these world concerns to you because you are the God of not only this community, but of the entire world. And we just lift the families of the shooting up to you, and we pray that you will be with all of the governments as they try to control the things going on in the Far East. We just pray that you will keep people safe and that your peace would rule in this world. And now let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our words of grace today. As we continue during this Advent pilgrimage, we look to God for peace. We are people who seek to be brought together by the peace we discover in Christ. Our faith teaches us that God gives us peace overflowing. We are thankful for God's presence this season, and as we worship God, may we recognize God as the source of all hope and peace. We come this morning to show our gratitude with great peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our Old Testament reading today comes to us from Isaiah chapter 26. You will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord The Lord himself is the rock eternal. He humbles those who dwell on high. He lays the lofty city low. He levels it to the ground and casts it down to the dust. Feet trample it down, the feet of the oppressed, the footsteps of the poor. The path of the righteous is level. You, the upright one, make the way of the righteous smooth. Yes, Lord, walking in the way of your laws, we wait for you, your name, and your renown are the desires of our hearts. And then from Luke chapter 2, when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. And may God add the blessing to the reading of his word.
If you'd like to follow the melody of this piece, it's on in the hymn book on page 130. And it's the melody is in the pedals, and it's in slow motion.
Away all the time. It's amazing. I just looked up and it's usually like 20 till. And so anyway, without any further ado, last week we talked about hope, and this week we are talking about peace. Today, I think that's something that's very hard for us to find, and I think that peace comes to us even in difficult times. Peace is something that I think has been really hard for us to find over the last couple of years, and it's something that we took for granted, I believe. And I also think that when we are at peace, we are less aware of being at a place of peace than when we're not. Would you agree with that? When we're not at peace, we're very aware of it. But when we are at peace, we just take it for granted. This morning in our readings, in our text this morning, it said in one of those verses, it said, God will keep us in perfect peace, those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. He will keep us in perfect peace. So our ability to be at peace or to find peace actually comes from trusting God. I don't know if you noticed in our call to worship today, we read many verses. Each call to worship was a different verse about peace. And as I was reading them in preparation for today, I was thinking that for me, it's a matter of mind over matter. Quoting them from memory to put our minds in that place that we call peace. And just as the Bible verse says, as any man thinks in his heart, so is he. I think our ability to be at peace is also coming from what we put in our mind, what is in our head. And I think that peace is a place, I think that's a place I want to hang out. But that's easier said than done. Because finding peace at Christmas can be an extra challenging journey. We all know that Christmas can mean so many things. For kids, what's it all about? What did Willow tell us last week? It was all about the presents. You're doing good, Morgan. Don't be shaking your head no. Every kid, even you, thought that at Christmas. For some of us, it's about family time, which may involve all kinds of warm feelings, or it can be challenging to be together with family or time with friends. But for many, the holiday season hopefully brings a break at the end of a busy year. But this week, as we continue down our Advent journey, this week we are reminded the fact that heaven is celebrating peace as we proclaim God's peace in the coming of his child, his birth. Isaiah 9 says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be on his shoulders, and he shall be called the Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace." I'm surprised Ben didn't jump up to the organ and start playing Handel's Messiah. But I think we find the sense of peace to be a little bit contradictory at Christmas time. We may find peace hard to hold on to as we go through the busyness. I went out to the mall again this week. It wasn't busy. There was no one there. It was like a ghost town. But Target, still busy. And I thank you, Paula, for turning our minds to a global level here in church. I think when it comes to peace, we see the need for peace in the world more than ever. There are wars always going on, and they may not always be actual wars. I think in the last months we've had different sides of wars on the COVID issue and knowledge of what is fact and what is fiction. But there is always going to be, unfortunately, wars going on, whether small or big. But still, we see the sense of celebration at Christmas time and the birth of Christ, that as last week we discovered that it offers hope, and that hope leads us to a place of peace. We need to find peace within us, because safe to say that human souls long for peace as much as any other thing. Studies show that anxiety comes from rapid change, and that such change can take our stress levels off the charts. A recent survey taken at the National Center for Health and Statistics found that more than half of all Americans have suffered moderate excessive stress in the past 2 weeks, and the Surgeon General said 2 out of every 3 illnesses prior to the age of 65 are preventable because they are directly related to stress. So we as Christians have good news. God places peace in the center of Christmas. And the Bible also makes clear that God has a different perspective on peace than we often do. We think of peace as simply the absence of something stressful. But peace in the Bible is rooted in the birth of Jesus. They have a word called shalom. And shalom expresses not simply the absence of something, but of being connected, of being settled and secure, and like the satisfaction we get when we are at peace. Shalom expresses true internal peace. Martin Luther King was fond of a saying that says, true peace is not merely the absence of some negative force, tension or war, it's the presence of some positive force. Peace is not the absence of trouble, but the presence of God. John 16 says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. Jesus tells us that we can expect to have trouble, and at the same time we can experience peace. The Bible says that the core of our human condition lies within our ability to find peace. The Bible also says that this life-giving peace comes only when the human spirit is united with the Spirit of Christ, which has been born into this world. Again, from John 14, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you, not as the world gives it do I give you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Over the next couple weeks, the whole Christmas story sums up the great truth behind a baby's birth. God in human flesh, God Emmanuel, God with us, and that he can bring us the peace that lasts, that will hold us firm in times like this. Because in this child born on Christmas Day, we see God's peace and we see God's hope. As we celebrate Christmas as the birth of Jesus, the prophesied Messiah, Jesus came to bring hope and peace and forgiveness and change for the hearts of people. Much like our tagline of the denomination, that no matter who you are, wherever you are in life's journey, you're welcome here. The shepherds help us see that God has a message for people just like us. The peace of Christmas comes to us in the verse we read at the beginning of the service. God's peace is offered to the world. The peace begins with peace with God. God promised to give us peace. His purpose is to give us peace. If we can't find peace with God, the Christmas message is missed. So may we find that Christmas message this week, that we might bring peace, the peace that brought Jesus Christ, God, down to earth as a little baby, as we celebrate this Advent season. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for the hope we have in you. I thank you for the peace that you give us throughout life. And at times when we are less aware of it, may we seek your face. And may we be thankful and joyful when we have that peace that only comes from knowing you. I pray that you will be with this congregation this week as we go out. May you fill us with your peace, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Our closing hymn is Away in a Manger.
That's all. all stand.
Interested in membership, fill out the thing or talk to me after church. And am I forgetting anything? Council meeting Wednesday. Christmas cards in the back. They're starting to accumulate. So save yourself about 10, 15 bucks, 55, and bring them back there if that's a tradition that you choose to participate in. And may the peace of God be with you all this week as we go out to spread the hope and the peace of Jesus. Amen.
Because I'm next to them.
Oh, I got you. I want to make it. I went.